Hey guys, what's up? I'm Morgan. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also turn on the notifications so you can see that I'm uploading. I'm trying to upload at least every week, but you know, life gets in the way. If you're returning, welcome back, pull up a chair. We're now in part two of my foundation series. Again, something I've wanted to do for a really long time. If you haven't watched part one, go ahead and watch that. It's my rundown of my favorite high-end foundations. I think you'll enjoy it. I think if you're looking for some ideas and some reviews, quick and easy pros and cons of high-end foundations, that will be able to help you. So let's go ahead and get into my top five drugstore foundations. Probably one of the first, I wanna say this is one of the first super full coverage drugstore foundations that came out. It is the Maybelline Super Stay Full Coverage Foundation. I will just say one thing about this foundation. I'll say more, but it's like paint. If anybody has tried this foundation, you'll know that when you put it on, it is full coverage. I mean, this is probably one of the most full coverage foundations that I own, but I don't necessarily think it's a good thing, if that makes sense. I don't necessarily want to look like I have a mask on my face, and this is thick and full coverage. It looks like a mask. It dries, it photographs really well, but in real life, especially after a few hours, it's gonna look cakey. It's gonna look like you have a thick layer on your face, and a lot of people don't like that look. If you like that look, more power to you, but it's just not really my thing. So I'm the shade 312 Golden Ore in this foundation. I do think it does photograph well. I think it is super full coverage. Obviously you can shear it down if you need to. If this is the only thing you have in your bag, you can shear it down. I'm not a huge fan of this shade range in these. I think they could have a little bit more warmth in them. Golden Ore to me is very neutral pink. There's nothing golden about it, but this does work for me in the winter if I'm looking for something that is super full coverage and just need to slather it on for some pictures. It works for that, I will say that. So again, let me give you a review of my skin tone, my skin type, and what I'm looking for. My skin tone, it changes. In the winter, it's very neutral. It's a little bit lighter, of course, but it's more neutral. It has more of a neutral undertone. As I go into the summer months, I get more golden, but not too yellow, just a little golden. I like a little bit more brown in my skin. So that is why I will have a smattering of like kind of different shades, and you'll see that as I swatch these in the videos. As far as my skin type, I'm combination oily. I can say that for the most part, the oil sticks to my nose, a little bit my forehead, but mostly my nose, and I almost always will have some sort of oil peeking throughout the day, which is normal, but depending on the foundation and depending on the primers that I use, I can kind of control that. So if you have skin type like me, you'll kind of understand what I'm talking about. Number four, and this came out of left field for me, I'm not gonna lie, I really wasn't thinking this was gonna work. Number four, it's gotta be the Conceal and Perfect Milani Foundation Stick. I was impressed. Not only was I impressed with the shade that I found in this, this is 260 Warm Sand. I'll start off by saying they do not have nearly enough shades in this foundation, and Warm Sand is not warm. It is neutral. It almost runs a little pink, in my opinion. I think their shade names and their shade ranges need a lot of work. But because it's the winter and because I'm more neutral, Warm Sand is a perfect spot on match for me. It doesn't make me look washed out. It doesn't make me look gray. It doesn't look too yellow or too red. It's a perfect spot on match for me. I don't like stick foundations either, but I can tell you that this one is super blendable, super moisturizing. The only problem you're gonna have with this foundation is you're gonna have to set it with powder. I don't like setting my foundations with powder. Some people love it, some people don't think it's a big deal. I am not one of those people. I like to just put my foundation on, keep going through my steps, and go. The only thing that I'm putting, only powder I'm really putting on my face normally, I don't even like to set my concealers, to be honest, but sometimes I set my concealer. The only powder I normally put on my face, though, is a contour. I like to use powder contour. That's really the only thing I like to use, that's powder. But if you set this with a powder, you will not be disappointed with the way that it wears, you will not be disappointed with the way that it looks on the skin. It is light to medium coverage. I probably wouldn't put on more than two layers of this because then it will start to settle and fine lines. But as far as on the go, carry it. You can literally spread this on with your hands if you want to. Just apply it with the stick and then massage it into your face and you're good to go. Honestly, if you're not looking for something that's super fussy, this thing is amazing. I think it's only like $10. Definitely came out of nowhere on this one. It just came out too. Number three is my NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Foundation. This stuff is amazing. Like, you can tell how well used it is by looking at the applicator on this thing. This stuff is amazing. The concealer is amazing. The whole thing. I've done a video on this. Go ahead and check out the video on the foundation. I've also done a video on the concealer. NYX really came through on this formula. I also love the shade range on this foundation. There are at least three other colors in the shade range that I can use depending on the type of year it is or what I'm looking for. If I'm looking for something a little bit more warm, if I get really, really tan, or I'm looking for something more neutral, this is that foundation. I love it. It definitely is long wear. Transfer resistant, I'm gonna have to say no on that. I think it does transfer pretty easily, actually. Not as bad as some foundations, but obviously, if I'm comparing this to an Estee Lauder Double Wear, I'm gonna say it's not really in that same category. But for a drugstore foundation, it does a great, great job, and the price point isn't bad. The only con that I can think of on this foundation is that it clogs the pump. I don't know if I'm the only one that's realized this or noticed this, or maybe I can't be alone, because if you've used this foundation and you use it more than a few times, every time you use it, the pump gets clogged. I've literally sprayed my wall with foundation because I've been trying to get the pump out. I have to literally dig it out in order to get the foundation out. So that's my only con with this, but other than that, I love this foundation. I think it's a great, great buy. This one, number two. L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Fresh Wear. This came out of left field as well. I'm telling you, these drugstores are coming up and coming for our money this year. I think out of my top five, three of them came out in the past 3 months. Like, this is coming for everyone's money. This is a beautiful, beautiful foundation. The shade range, 50 shades, impeccable. Like, I love it. 500, I'm the shade 500 in this one. I think it is actually usable for winter and a little bit into summer. Maybe not the peak summer season when I'm like super tan, but like this wears beautifully, I think, and will work for both seasons. My pores disappear with this, which I think is very interesting because I've never really had that happen before. Medium coverage, I'm not gonna say super full. I'm gonna say it's medium. It is buildable. I love that it's a pump. The pump is really nice, really easy to use. I really don't have much bad to say about it. I do think, however, that it doesn't stick to the oily places as much as I'd want it to. So my nose does see a little bit of separation if I'm wearing this for more than 8 to 9 hours. I do see a little separation in the nose area. I do see a little cracking here, but it's nothing that I'm like, don't want to use the foundation anymore, you know? Like, it's still pretty good. Again, what I'm looking for in foundations, just to recap everything, I want something that'll stick to me 8 hours a day. I'm at work. I don't have time to be blotting. I don't have time to add powder. I do wear glasses. So I don't want something that's constantly picking up off of my nose in that area because it just looks bad. You know, I have my glasses on and off during the day. When I'm talking to somebody up close, they can see that there's lines. It just isn't cute. And I also want something that matches and I don't have to do too much fuss with. I don't want to have to apply it and then have to color correct or go back in and it's picking up in certain places or it's patchy or it's drying. I want something that just makes my face look flawless so I can go to work, get my job done, come home, and wash my face off. It also has photographed pretty well. I will say the Morphe foundation does photograph really, really well as the Infallible ones. So number one, and I know some people are gonna be like, what, number one? Morphe. The Morphe Fluidity Foundation, I don't understand why it was so talked about, why it was so hated upon when it first came out. This foundation is amazing. Hands down, price point $18, shade range amazing. The shades, like the way they did the shade range is a little funky, like 3.0, 3.2, 3.20, 3.10, 3.1, they're like all different, right? So I'm 3.3, I also have 3.2, which I think I can get away with in the winter, and 3.4 and 3.5, or 3.3, I have two other ones, I bought four of these basically. that I think will be my summer shade. But right now, 3.30 is my shade. I love this foundation. I use it almost every day. It is super full coverage, but it's full coverage without looking cakey. It doesn't dry super, super badly. Like, it's not drying, if that makes sense. It is matte. It's not drying. I've gotten so many compliments on this foundation, it's ridiculous. I will throw this on with a little bit of oil underneath my skin, like a little bit of beauty oil, maracuja oil, whatever, and people will just say, oh my gosh, your skin looks flawless. Things that I'm not even trying to do, thinking that I'm not even doing anything with my makeup, every time I wear this, I get some sort of compliment. I love the way it wears. I love that it's in a little tube. A lot of people don't like the tube. I don't mind the tube because it means I can close it, throw it in my bag, and I can go. The brush, it applies beautifully with a brush or a sponge. I mean, it's just, I can't get enough of this foundation. I think it's really good. I'm not even sure if you would consider Morphe drugstore. I do because it's under the $20 price point. So I'm gonna say this is drugstore. I'm also gonna say it's drugstore because you can't get it in Sephora. And I think all high-end you can get Sephora. So that is my rationale for that. All right, guys, that's all for my drugstore foundations. Again, this is just my top five, my go-tos, the ones that I seem to always be picking up because they seem to work and they get the job done and I don't have to spend a huge amount of time perfecting my base. I will talk to you guys later. If you have any questions or if you have any drugstore foundations that you think I should try, leave it down below. Let me know, I'd love to try it. I love foundation, base is everything in my opinion. I think you can pretty much do anything simply with your makeup if your base looks good. So yeah, I will talk to you guys later. Go ahead and watch part one and stay tuned for part three, which is the foundations that are problematic. For me, they might work well for everyone else, but for me, they're problematic. So I'll talk to you guys later. Have a good one. Bye.